Shantiniketan. So what are the aspects we discussed in the last class is, see, after the interval, the students, they were taking their asana, that is seats, a square carpet, they were going to the ground, they were sitting individually, they were sitting alone, and they were starting the meditation. So after 10:30, when the school works begin, there were no classrooms, there were no larger classes. So all or a group of 8 to 10 students, they were sitting under the tree, they were discussing with the teachers, they were open up, they were discussing all the problems, they were asking the doubts, they were asking the queries very easily, without any hesitation. Means it shows the bonding, the relationship between a teacher and a student were very healthy. The students were not feeling any kind of a fear, any kind of a hesitation to ask the questions. Means there were no barriers. There were no barriers between the teacher and a student. So by seeing this, the teacher was very keen. He was very deep interest to answer all the questions of the students. So such kind of a education can never be done. Means it won't give, it won't feel any bore to the student. So after this, when the students come back, they take a bath, they will have their lunch. So around after 2 o'clock, there were no any book, there were no any work related with the books. The students were let out to do the handiwork, and this time all the work was related to the hand as well as the mind. Some of the students were preferred the mechanical work, some of the students prefer spinning and weaving, some of the students prefer musicians, some of the students prefer the drawings. We call it as a what? We call it the draftsman. Fine. So as soon by seeing this, the teacher can easily identify the taste of the student. So this is what we discuss, right? So morning, afternoon. Now at the time of evening, what are the activities which are done by the children of Shantiniketana, will come to know. Okay. See, observe the textbook here, paragraph 6. There is a very little book work in the afternoon. School is over about 4 o'clock, and then there is a rush to get first into the great open field for football. Our Shantiniketana boys are famous everywhere for the sports and games. In the evening, at sunset, they return from the fields and sit down once more for a short time to meditate in silence. As night comes, fairy tales are told, short dramas are recited, our Gurudeva's songs are sung, and different school gatherings are held. By 9 o'clock, all are glad to retire to rest, and again the choristers go round the ashram singing their last evening hymn. There can be no question as to the happiness of the life of our boys. Their faces tell the story of their joy and their freedom. There is no freer life in India than the life of our children at Shantiniketan. Okay? There is a very little book work in the afternoon. As I said, in the afternoon, there are no book work. It is a very few, because all the students were let out to do the handiwork, where most of the work is with the hands as well as the mind. So there is very little book work in the afternoon. School is over at about 4 o'clock. Like the same, our school, it will finish around 4:45, right? So like the same way, the Shantiniketana or the ashrama, at that time, the school will be completed at 4 o'clock. And there is a rush to get into the great open fields for football. In between, in an interval, if a teacher comes to you and they will tell, so and so teacher is on leave, so that period you can go to the ground. So at how you will go? You will go in a silent way. You will show you exaggerate, right? You will show your happiness, you will run, you will rush towards the open field, right? So what is the meaning of rush? Hurry. Okay, so after the school complete around 4 o'clock, there is a rush to get first into the great open field for football. All the students, they make hurry, they make rush. What is the meaning of rush? Hurry. They make hurry for what? To go to the great open field. For what purpose? To play the football. Very good. To play football. There is a rush to get first into the great open field for football. Our Shantiniketana boys are famous everywhere for the sports and games. The boys of the Shantiniketana, they are very famous. Among from other schools, they are very famous for what? For their sports and games. Fine. In the evening, at sunset, they return from the field and sit down once more for a short time to meditate in silence. In the evening, after the completion of playing, in the evening, during the or at the time of the sunset. At the time of sunset means, it means evening. At the time of a sunset, they return back. Now at present they are in a field. So in the evening, all the students who are playing football in the great open field, they are coming back, they are returning back from the field, and what they are doing? They are sit down and sit down once more. Again they are going to sit down in a group for a short time for the meditation. For what purpose? See, evening after the completion of the school, there is a rush towards to go to the great open field to play the football. So at the evening, when the sun is about to set, all the students are coming back. They are coming back from the great open field. They will sit down once again and again they will start meditation. Okay, they will start meditation. As night comes, fairy tales are told, short dramas are recited, our Gurudeva songs are sung, and different school gatherings are held. Now, finally, evening complete, morning completed, afternoon is completed, evening is completed. Now it is the time of night. Fine. At night, finally, the night comes. At night comes, fairy tales are told. How they are going to spend the night time before they go to bed? The fairy tales. Fairy means, usually fairy means an angel. Our grandparents used to tell us. Undurali, Ubajit Lamte. Like this, right? Like the same way, fairy tales means it is an imaginary story of an angel. Okay, an imaginary one. We don't know whether an angel or a fairy exists or not, but it is an imaginary one. As night comes, fairy tales are told, short dramas are recited. Short dramas. Skits. What do you call? Skits. Short dramas are recited. What is the meaning of recited? Sing or narrate. Okay, you can also tell, sing or narrate. So at the night time, fairy tales are going to tell and short dramas are recited. Our Gurudeva songs are sung. The children of the Shantiniketana, usually they don't sing any film songs. Okay, the songs which is written by the Gurudeva. Gurudeva is also called the students of the Shantiniketana. They mention Rabindranath Tagore and what? Yes, very good. Gurudeva. So instead of singing the movie songs, instead of singing some other kind of a songs, what songs are have been sung by the students of Shantiniketan? Our Gurudevas means the poems, the songs which are written by the Rabindranath Tagore, they were singing them. Our Gurudeva songs are sung and different school gatherings are held. And also they gather some different school gathering. What is the meaning of gathering? Function. Some small functions they are going to organize before going to the bed. By 9 o'clock, all are glad to retire. So, by the time of 9 o'clock, after completion of the dinner, all are glad. What is the meaning of glad? It is the end of the day, 9 o'clock. It is the end of the happier, busier and very beautiful end of the day. What is the meaning of glad? Happy. And then all the students, very happy. Before going to the bed, they feel very happy. Why? Because they are remembering the entire day they have been completed by many number of activities. So, by 9 o'clock, all are glad to retire. What is the meaning of retire? Preparing to go to sleep or go to the bed. Okay. All are happy or glad to retire to rest. Means to rest means they are going to. They are almost ready to go to bed. They are almost ready to go to sleep. And again the five ministers go around the ashram singing their last evening hymn. Their day in the ashram, their day starts from singing the morning hymn. Like I say, their day ends by singing the last hymn. The choristers go around the ashram singing the last evening hymn. There can be no question as to the happiness of the life of our boys. Means by seeing the face, one can easily tell the student, the child of the Shantiniketana. They are leading a very happy life. There can be no question as to the happiness of the life. There is no doubt for the life of the boys who lives in the Shantiniketana. Means, if you are going to ask whether you are happy, compulsorily they are telling the answer, yes, we are not only happy, we are extreme happy. We are extreme happy. There can be no question as to the happiness of the life of our boys. Their faces tell the story of their joy and their freedom. Just by seeing the face of the boys who resides in Shantiniketana, one can easily tell that they are leading their lives with complete joyness and complete freedom. There is no free life in India than the life of our children at Shantiniketana. When it comes to the other schools of our India, none other school can give you complete freedom to live in a school, right? So, see why we are telling that there is a complete freedom and a school in entire India. There is no other place where the student can live with all the freedom. The major point is, subjects are not compulsory, right? In the Shantiniketana, till what we discussed, did we discuss any kind of a word called as a subject? No. It means there is no compulsion of the subject. Sir, I don't need this subject. Whether you like it or not, you have to read it. This is the compulsion, right? But in the Shantiniketana, there is no such kind of a restrictions. No subject is compulsory. Okay? So, whether the student like or dislike, you can do whatever you want to do. That is very positive, not negative. Which is very positive, which is very good, which is healthier. You can do all the things. So by saying this, we will conclude the lesson. If any doubts, if you find any queries in the interaction class, we will discuss this. So overall, so what is the summary? What do we understand by this lesson? See, there are two education patterns. One education pattern is of a Shantiniketana and one education pattern what we are following today. Although, my dear students, the system may be differ from that school to our school. The work pattern may be differ from that school to our school. But the motive, but the objective, but the aim is same. And what is that aim or motive or objective? To make the children lead a comfortable life, to make the children live with the morals and values, to make the children compete with the other people, to make the students or to make the children survive in a better way. So these are the common aim. In Shantiniketana education system, the education system gives much importance to the same thing. Whereas the other education system, there may be, ideology may be changed, but the overall objective is the same. So finally, we will conclude this by, see, here is a beautiful statement. See what it is? Education is not just going to school or getting a degree. It's about widening your knowledge and absorbing the truth about life. not education, it doesn't mean you are going to which kind of a school, or you are going to school, you have completed degrees, you have many degrees. It is not that. Education is not only meant for going to school and getting the degrees, but the real meaning of the education is you have to observe. You have to observe the knowledge. You have to seek the knowledge, and you have to what? Know the truth about life. You have to know the truth about life. What is the truth about life? Truth about life is nothing but preparing ourselves to face the challenges and problems. Preparing ourselves means preparing yourself to face the challenges. This is the actual meaning of what? The education. Okay? So, the one who study in a Shantiniketan, easily he will get success in his life. It doesn't mean in another school you won't get, but majority you will get success easily in such kind of a school. The best example, our PM, late Indira Gandhi, she was a student of Shantiniketan. Fine. So here we'll conclude this lesson. Fine. Thank you.